Here we go with our trader game, Top That Trade. Joining us now, our favorite traders, Phil Flynn, a Fox Business Network contributor, and Alan Uckman, an options trading pro. Round number one, guys, Facebook testimony. Did you like CEO Mark Zuckerberg's comments to Congress enough to buy, hold, or sell the stock?
I didn't like having to sit through 2 days. I mean, there were no in-depth questions, but the market did like it. We saw a relief rally in the stock. We're back to near that 170 level. This is stock that traded between 170 and 190 for 6 months before this breakdown. Now, if we can get back inside that channel, that target's 210, 25% and above. It's not over in Facebook.
I thought Mark Zuckerberg was going to cry. I really did. He looked like he was going to break down in tears.
He looked like that guy from Star Trek.
I know. As soon as they said, you know, are you a monopoly? I go, I don't feel like a monopoly.
His wallet feels like a monopoly.
It was a bad week for billionaires. I mean, getting up there and, you know, but, you know, I'll tell you what.
There's no such thing as a bad week for billionaires.
Oh, I think it was. We'll talk about it later. But at the end of the day, I like Facebook. I think it was overdone on the selling. But they really have to get their act together because I do think they could be open for competition, especially if the Congress wants to help that along a bit.
I think regulation's more concerned. Competition, there really isn't any right now. But that can always change. There's some guy in his dorm room right now coming up with something else.
He is, absolutely. And keep working and call me. Call me.
Round number two, reason season. It is now a new earnings season with the banks reporting in and the market getting back to fundamentals. What do you see as some pockets of strength in the stock market?
I think the banks are back and you're going to be in trouble. You got to love the banks, right?
That's why they keep money in them.
I'm telling you, the rates are going up. It's, you know, you heard from the Federal Reserve that they're going to be raising rates. They feel more hawkish about the economy. Let me tell you, a rising rate environment is great for banks. So you want to stay long the banks, of course. I like Citi down here. They've been beat up a little bit. I think that's a stock you can jump in.
Wells Fargo's been crushed.
It has been. So I like Wells Fargo as well.
So maybe someday that could come back. The sector I like?
Yeah.
Yours. Energy.
Well, yeah, we've been talking about that.
We're going to 75. If you look at the charts, it looks like 75 in crude oil. We had this breakout above 67.
Yeah.
So we took out that double top, new three, almost four-year highs. So there's a lot of energy stocks that can start to play ball.
Oh, you guys are full of energy today. Let's take it on to round number three. Profit problem. Hedge fund star John Paulson will have to pay $1.5 billion to Uncle Sam with taxes. So is this a high-class problem?
I told you it was a bad week for billionaires. I told you it was a bad week for
billionaires. It's not a bad thing to have to pay $1.5 billion in tax if you made $4 billion. Actually, he ended up making $15 billion.
But so
he just shifted the profits. He shifted the profits forward.
Yeah.
The lesson to be learned here is the more money you make, you know, that then you might have a tax liability, but don't trade because of your tax situation.
Right.
You can work around that. But I wanted to point out.
So is this how they get to the fact where the top 1% pay 70 or 80% of the taxes? It's because of guys like this?
Maybe. Okay, my point was that he made all his money on the downside a long time ago, and there's money to be made on the upside. So it doesn't matter what the market conditions. Markets aren't good or bad. They just are. There's ways to make money, and obviously big money. His big position now is gold.
Ooh, and that hasn't done very well.
Well, it just rallied up to 2 month highs. If we can break above 1370, then you could see a quick run up to 1450.
The last time we were at 2 months high were 2 months ago, and we didn't go anywhere.
Well, here's your bonus round question for today. It's one or the other. The word tariff, does it come from the English word tarry, which means to delay or slow, or the English word tar, which of course is sticky liquid?
I go with the big sticky liquid all the time.
That's always your answer.
That's always my answer.
So then I'll pick the first version.
The answer is tar.
Thank you very much. I'll tell you, when it comes to tar and sticky stuff, don't mess with me.
Check out businessfirstam.com to find out where to see our entire show. And don't forget to like, follow, and share Business First AM.